fiercest females we've had on this show. She's earned the nickname the Female Indiana Jones for her wildlife explorations on the National Geographic Channel. She's also a Fulbright scholar, and I think this is the most baddest thing of all. She's a mom of six. Please welcome Mireya Mayor.
Thank you.
Hey, Mireya, how are you?
Thank you.
So how did all this happen? How did you become—
The six kids?
Yeah.
No, I think we got that covered.
Valentine's Day? That happened?
Right.
Yeah. But the Female Indiana Jones, I love that name. That's got to be quite an honor. I mean, he's I know you got to meet Harrison Ford, too.
Yeah, so for, I think, 15 years now, I've been referred to as the Female Indiana Jones in the media. So I finally had the chance to meet Harrison Ford and have dinner with him. And I said, for just one night, you are going to be the male Dr. Mireya Mayor.
Nice. And you even got him to smile. I've met Harrison. He doesn't smile a lot.
Yeah, so, well, look at her. He's taking a picture with her.
Yes. We were talking about conservation and animals, which he's very passionate about.
Yes, he is.
And so are you. And this love and this passion came kind of by accident from taking an anthropology class that fit in your schedule?
Yeah, so I've always loved animals. I had a zoo at home with dogs, cats, a pet chicken, you name it. I had everything. But I didn't know that I could really have a career in that, and I was a pre-law student. I was majoring in English and philosophy, and I had to take a science requirement. And anthropology was the only class that fit my schedule. So I thought, right, I'll sign up for that, and it changed the entire course of my life.
Isn't that amazing?
I saw images of Diane Fossey with gorillas and Jane Goodall with the chimps, and it was like my aha moment. I'm like, that's what I want to do forever.
Yeah, and Jane actually wrote the foreword in your book.
She did.
Yeah, that quite an honor.
My hero.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I mean, she's a legend.
She is a legend.
Yeah.
And every time I see her, I lose the ability to speak.
Right. You've been on countless adventures.
Yes.
What's your favorite?
Oh my goodness.
I know, that's a tough question. I know.
I have truly loved them all. One that stands out for me is walking, you know, trekking across Africa 1,000 miles and spending time with the Maasai warriors. And, you know, we walk into a rainforest and we see trees.
Yeah.
And they walk into a rainforest and they see a medicine cabinet. And it's just really amazing how much you can learn from them. So that was an incredible experience.
Yeah.
And any of the six kids go with you?
Yes, so I started taking my oldest, who's now 13, when she was about 10 months old. Now, she's a dancer and not so into losing the modern comfort. But I do have an 11-year-old who, from the time she could speak, would say, I want to follow in your footsteps.
Aww.
And, she dresses up like me, like when she goes to school on career day. And I finally got to take her to Madagascar. And my gosh, did she impress me. She was just in her element.
Wow, she's impressing us with these photos.
Completely
she's not
comfortable,
at all.
Not afraid of anything. I mean, I lost her in the forest, truth be told, several times, because she would just run off and find animals and come back and report back. I mean, she loved it so much.
Wow. So
I think we have a future Jane Goodall in
right.
her.
Right, that's going to get passed down a generation there. But there are real dangers that you face. I mean, what are some of the scary moments that you've dealt with?
Well, let's see. I've been charged by silverbacks, which are 400-pound male gorillas that, you know, most of the time they're bluffing and you know it's a bluff charge. And what you do is you act submissive, which is very easy to do in front of a 400-pound gorilla.
Right.
You crouch down, you try to look smaller, you don't make eye contact, and you pretend to be eating leaves. In some cases, it's scary enough
that
you. Well, you don't really want to punch someone who has food in their mouth, right?
So yeah, yeah.
If you act like another gorilla, they're usually like, all right, they're not really trying to attack. But I have had silverbacks who meant business. They were one in particular I'll never forget. He'd had a really bad day with all the other female gorillas. They wouldn't do anything that he wanted to do.
Maybe he was a player.
Right. Yeah. I think he was definitely a player. He was the only male in, you know, with his harem, right? But they would not. They were just making him so upset, and they all left. All the females left. I was the only female that stayed behind, and he just at one point looked at me like, okay, now you need to go, and he just jumped, and I mean, he leapt into the very spot I was standing in, and in that case, I did not follow textbook. I didn't crouch down. I got out. I got out of its way.
Yeah.
But, you know, forest elephants. I was in a plane crash in Congo.
Oh,
that's a whole other story. Ended up having to stay in a brothel, whole other story.
Oh, and it was like... you sure you want your daughter to follow your footsteps?
Not
Does
that
she know
one.
This part of the life?
Yeah. Not yet.
Yeah.
Not yet.
What would you say is your biggest achievement?
I feel very proud of having co-discovered the world's smallest primate. It's a little mouse lemur in Madagascar. It weighs less than 2 ounces. And more proud is that because of this discovery, I was able to approach the president and the prime minister of Madagascar, and they declared the area a national park.
Oh, that's amazing.
So it protected, you know, the thousands of species in Madagascar that are endangered, this tiny little creature.
What advice would you give to budding explorers?
I would say, I always say, follow your passion, follow your dream, whatever that is. For budding explorers in particular, get out there. You know, there's so much to explore, even in your own backyards, and then you can start taking it further and further and getting a little bit more adventurous, if you will. But if that's something that you're passionate about, don't let anyone stop you. Believe me, I had never left the country. I had, my parents are Cuban immigrants, totally overprotective. I asked them if I could join the Girl Scouts, and they said, no way, too dangerous. You know, I'd never been camping, and I was a former NFL cheerleader on top of it. So had no sort of background in this at all. So I just say, do it.
Wow. You've lived some incredible lives, actually. Yes. You have an event tonight. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, so I'm going to be speaking at the auditorium tonight at 7 p.m., and I'm going to be sharing a lot of the behind the scenes of my adventures and the filming, a lot of the mishaps, a lot of the dangerous parts, but also, you know, sharing in the National Geographic legacy these amazing photographs that I hope will have people falling in love with these places and animals.
Yeah. Will you be telling the story of the plane crash in the Congo?
I might have to now.
And the problem. Okay.
Yes, you can see more with Mireya tonight at the Auditorium Theater. Info is at the bottom of your screen right there.